This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, Discover Newport has brought us Chef Alexandra Day from Newport Cooks. Good morning, Alexandra.
Good morning.
Nice to see you.
Thank you for having me.
And this morning, you guys know I've been waiting to say this all morning. We are making salade niçoise.
Exactly.
Thank you, everyone.
Yes. Perfect pronunciation.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much. And tell us a little bit about the ingredients we're working with for this fine dish.
Okay. Well, this is a traditional French salad. It's a composed salad. So there is a Boston bib lettuce. We have niçoise olives, of course. Fresh tomatoes, which we will cut and quarter. I have blanched green beans over there as well.
Nice.
The potatoes here are already blanched and still warm. Hard-boiled eggs, sliced red onion, chiffonade of basil. I have some chopped chives.
Mm-hmm.
I have some seasoned tuna that we will sear in just a minute as well. And
All
then
right.
the mise en place for the vinaigrette is a red wine vinaigrette.
I am very excited to sample here by the time we're all done here this morning. And this is a great, you know, thing for the summertime, isn't it? People can throw this together if they're having guests over or if they're just flying solo for dinner or for lunch. It's a nice thing that they can make, isn't it?
It is. It's a very easy salad, which was the impetus behind this as a lesson for our kids' cooking camps that we're holding in the second and third week of July.
That's a really cool thing. We'll talk about that more later, I'm sure. And yeah, this is something that people can actually tackle themselves. They don't need to be intimidated by all the ingredients. They hear salade niçoise, and they might be a little intimidated, but they really don't have to be, do they?
No. This is very easy, and I will show everybody how to set yourself up for success, and you can plan ahead and prep ahead, and it's a perfect party pleaser.
Are you saying that even somebody like me would have no trouble making this?
Absolutely, I promise.
I love hearing that. All right, well, Alexandra, it's a pleasure to meet
you.
We are very much looking forward to what you will be assembling for us here today.
Thank you.
And I can't wait to sample, as I said. It smells fantastic. We're going to be checking in with her all morning long and seeing how this all comes together. For now, back over to you.
Alexandra Day is here, Newport Cooks. We're getting ready to start putting stuff together,
yes,
right?
Yes,
All right,
we are.
What do we need to do?
Well, composed salad, we get everything prepared ahead of time, as I'd mentioned earlier. So one of the crucial elements to this recipe is the vinaigrette, which I'm going to utilize you for.
All right.
Being that this is one of the recipes we're using in our Newport Cooks Newport Cooks.
It's tough to say.
It's a tongue twister. The summer cooking camps for kids.
Mm-hmm.
This will exemplify to them how to poach items, how to blanch things, how to prep ahead, how to boil an egg. Very simple things.
Right.
One of the simple things is to how to prepare a vinaigrette.
Got it.
So here we have everything already measured out. I'd like you to take the mustard, put it in the jar.
Okay.
All of the garlic that's measured. All of that mustard.
Okay. Is this a spicy mustard?
It's a Dijon.
Dijon. All right. Love that.
We also have some fresh chopped thyme. Add about half of that.
Okay.
Perfect.
This in here.
Yep.
All of the garlic, you said,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Okay, got it.
About half of the fresh chopped thyme.
Okay.
All of this honey as well. The honey sort of sweetens it.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of mutes the acidic quality of it. The red wine vinaigrette.
Mm-hmm. All right.
You may need that.
See if we can scoop it out with this. Move it along.
And this is
here.
The easiest way to make a vinaigrette, which is again why we're using this recipe in our cooking camps, because you just throw everything in a jar.
And
the
let
vinegar
it go.
Is next.
Okay.
Salt and pepper. Always season.
And all of it.
Yep.
All of the vinegar.
Plenty.
Okay. Good.
A little bit of before the oil. We'll do the salt and pepper.
Okay.
And I'm just going to let you eye it about a teaspoon, just a couple of pinches.
I'm a salt guy.
Good.
You may want to eye it a little more.
Keep going.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. A little more.
A little more.
Okay.
One more pinch.
One more pinch. Oh, all right.
And a couple grinds of pepper. With this salad, you dress everything as you go. I already have the potatoes already dressed, and if they're dressed warm, they absorb the flavors a little bit better.
Then we can
add
the oil.
Yep.
Pour that right in.
And
I'll
tell you when. Stop.
Okay.
A little more. Add the lid tightly.
Put it on tight.
Screw it on and shake vigorously.
Okay, so make sure this
Glad
is tight.
This is you, not me.
Shake this up. We are good to go.
Yes.
We're going to put the rest of this salad together. Talk about all of the things that Newport Cooks has going on. In the meantime, back to you.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen where Discover Newport has brought us Newport Cooks. Chef Alexandra is here. We are making a fresh, simple, summery salad, right? This is perfect.
It's a salade niçoise. You're welcome.
Exactly. He's been loving saying that all morning long.
Practicing the French.
I've been working on it.
You have a lot of different ingredients kind of assembled here. You just made the dressing in the last segment with Will.
Exactly.
So bring us up to speed.
Okay, so again, this salad is a perfect example of what we're doing in our kids' cooking camps because it teaches the basics, teaches how to blanch vegetables, how to boil potatoes, how to boil an egg, which is often overrated.
That's hard to do.
Yes.
You know, something as easy as that, it can be very difficult.
Exactly, and we really want to instill through through this camp that if you teach the basics, mm-hmm. you can teach kids to create their own food.
Wow.
Another thing about this recipe, it's easily modifiable. You can change the fish if you'd like. You can use canned fish.
Mm-hmm.
The kids can be creative with the vegetables or the addition of vegetables or a different kind of lettuce. You know, some kids are really picky.
Yes.
So we want to teach them that there's no right or wrong and they can be creative.
Mm-hmm. Talk more about these camps. I mean, they really are giving the future culinary masters of America the tools they need. If kids want to get involved in this stuff, this is really where they need to be.
Yeah,
isn't it?
And if they're growing up with it, they're being creative, they have more of a say in what they're eating, and hopefully like to eat more and have mm-hmm. a healthier lifestyle.
That's great. Okay, so what can we help with
so
now?
Just to finish the salad.
I think I ought to enroll in one of those kids.
I have preheated. Please do.
Yeah,
please
they go. Need to.
We preheated this pan because now we're going to sear the tuna, mm-hmm. and we're just going to sear it very, very quickly over a high, high heat.
Okay.
Woo! You like to hear noise awesome. When you sear. Yeah. This is good.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice.
And how have you seasoned the
salt
the
and pepper
fish there?
Only?
Okay, letting it speak for itself.
Exactly. I'm going to turn it up a little bit more because as soon as you add the protein, the heat of the pan lessens.
Okay.
We really want a fast sear.
Right.
While that is searing, we'll just go ahead and start preparing the salad. Now, would you like to?
I'd love to do anything I can.
I would
do
love to
assist.
See you mount the potatoes in the center of the lettuce.
I can touch them.
You
or just...
can, or if you prefer, please use a spoon. But,
I'm going to use a spoon.
Okay.
All right, so I'll be doing this.
The potatoes there, are they dressed with anything?
They are dressed with a vinaigrette, yes.
Okay.
Everything, again, this is a composed salad. And mm-hmm. as Julia Child mentioned it when she did this in her cooking show.
You want them all on there?
You do, just, yep.
All right.
Well,
so
about half.
About half,
yeah.
All right.
It's a composed salad, so it's going to be beautifully arranged on a platter.
Mm-hmm.
You want to dress everything individually, so therefore you don't have to toss it right before you serve it. Otherwise, you negate the purpose of having it
guessing
composed.
This looks terrible.
You eat under the ice first.
Beautiful.
Isn't that what they say?
Exactly,
mm-hmm.
yes. So just go ahead and
move
use
around.
My fingers.
Toss
no, no, no.
Around.
More of a mound.
Okay. Oh, okay.
And then if you will have the tomatoes placed in four parts.
I can do that.
Just
like
about, again, half of what's there.
Chef, you mentioned of how this is, please help.
I'm here to help.
I'm
here
to help.
How about three wedges on each four corners?
Part. Yes. You mentioned before of how this is something that Julia Child would do.
Mm-hmm.
Someone else that worked a lot very closely with Julia Child was, of course, Jacques Pepin.
Yes.
And you said
this recipe is actually rewritten of his.
Mm-hmm.
He said, and this is something that has inspired me as I grew up cooking and learning, and he said, if you learn the basics, you learn to cook. From there, you can learn to create. So again, that's something we want to instill in these kids, that they mm-hmm. can create what they like, but you have to learn the basics first.
Right, I think Brendan's creating them.
You're making excellent points, and I'm
There's
so
no
sorry
right or wrong.
To interrupt,
that's fine.
But this is horrible. I tried so hard.
There we go. I'm just going to have
it's
to get my fingers in here.
Exactly.
I know. There is no wrong way,
exactly,
right, in the kitchen,
right.
Unless
now,
I'm doing it.
We're going to dress very quickly the green beans here.
Why don't you take that?
So you throw the green beans on there and the dressing, and we're actually going to get a finished shot how this all comes together to close out our show. But if you want the recipe, head on over to the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.
Thank you.